Hi guys, and welcome to Wonder HR. Thank you for visiting me again. In continuation to my earlier video on interview question and answer series, here I am with sample answer to another commonly asked question, which is, what are your strengths and weaknesses? In my earlier video, we have covered the very first question, which is very commonly asked, that is, tell me about yourself. I have given its link in the card above and the description box below. Please do watch that video as well after watching this video. So come, let's get started. Remember, you cannot mark these answers, understand the tip and the trick to answer it, and learn to face the interview confidently. Before we move further, if you are new to my channel, please take a moment and subscribe to Wonder HR. I am waiting. Please click on the subscribe button. Thank you. First, we start with certain tips and then we will gradually move forward to understand the examples of weaknesses, strength, and how we can use it in a statement form. So here are a few tips which will help us to answer this question. First, instead of just specifying it in words or in adjectives, you have to a real-time story or an experience ready to share for each strength you mention for yourself. This will help you to be highlighted and this will help you to stand out from other candidates. Like for example, if you say that problem solving is your strength, you should have a story created around this or a real-time incident which you can narrate to the interviewer, showcasing your problem solving as strength. Deep dive and analyze what exactly your strengths and weaknesses are. Do not copy from others. The more natural you are, the more confident you will sound. If you're not sure if what is your strength or weakness, please take help of a friend or a family member. Or you can take help of your colleague also. But remember, the person you're picking up should be very reliable, because if you choose a wrong person, you know the consequences. Your strength will become your weakness and your weakness might become your strength. So be very cautious on that. When you talk about your weaknesses, always add on ways by which you are overcoming them. This will depict your problem-solving approach. It's like, you know, you must have heard your managers at times telling you that come to me with solution, not with problems. So your weakness is your problem, right? So you have to find ways to fight it. You have to tell the interview what are the ways you are adopting to overcome this weakness. For example, if I say communication is my weakness and I am attending some workshops or I am talking to more and more people or I'm talking to myself front of the mirror or whatever steps you're taking to overcome this weakness, you should mention your ways to overcome it. When you are asked together about the strengths and weaknesses, you should always start with weaknesses first, followed by the strength, which means when an interview asks you a question as a club question, which is what are your strengths and weaknesses, at that time you have to first focus on your weakness, then your strength. There are times where the interviewer will ask you separately what are your strengths and what are your weaknesses. In that case, you have to answer to whatever he's asking. But when asked what are your strengths and weaknesses, focus on your weakness first. And you know why? Because you should leave a lasting impact on the interviewer. The last thing said by you will be on the top of his mind. Have your top three strengths and weaknesses ready to answer this question. During the course of the interview, you will be understanding the interviewer. You will be understanding the way he is asking you questions, what he is expecting from you. Be alert on that. Keep your three strengths and three weaknesses back of your mind ready to answer whenever asked. Club your strengths. Like when you're talking about your strengths, club your two to three strengths together in a statement. Of course, just don't mention multiple adjectives back to back. At the end of the video, we will know how we need to frame these sentences. So we'll park this right now and we'll talk later part of the interview. Relate to the job role. How can you relate your strengths and weaknesses to the job role? Only and only when you know the job description thoroughly. I keep on insisting to everybody, please, please ensure that you go through the job description, understand the in and out, and what are your, you know, what is expected from you or what the company is expecting from you. So accordingly, you can, you know, tweak a little here and there on your strengths and weaknesses. Last but not the least, which I also keep on repeating, mock, mock, mock. That's the only key to be pit-pat with your answers. Because if you forget it, you will not sound genuine. And then you know the consequences. Let's move forward and we'll talk about some weaknesses and ready-made statements in which you can use it. So first weakness, what we will understand is self-criticism. Now, people who have the tendency of self-criticism, they can frame their sentences like, I'm a very critical person. I am very critical, not of others, but more of myself. So whenever I complete a project, irrespective of whatever feedback I get from my client, good or bad, I am very conscious and I try to understand the gaps. I try to improve it more and more next time. So in spite of getting the appreciation, I am not very happy. I always feel something was left, some gap was there. But this is not the right way. What I'm doing is to overcome this is that I'm learning to improve it by celebrating every success and treasuring every moment. Next is for the people who are introvert. I'm an introvert person. I can say this is partially resolved after I became a team leader. This role demanded me to talk to people, share ideas, have their reviews, etc. I can say the work is still in progress, but I have improved drastically from the initial stages to the date. Till date, there is a lot of improvement in me. I feel the only reason I could improve myself from this is that I got more exposure. So personally, I have analyzed the more exposure I get, automatically I tend to become more better and more confident. I'm a very impatient and restless person. If project assigned to me or my team members seems to be not completed on time, I start doing vigorous follow-ups to have everybody on track, to have every moment's update of the project to me. During the process, I realize my teammate get a little irritated with me, which is not right. So what I'm doing is I'm going through regular meditation sessions to create calmness within myself. Next is initiative. I take a load of initiative. I tend to end up with so many things on my plate, which increases my workload. And then I fail to prioritize my work. I recently learned a tool in Excel to get organized with my work, and I'm strictly following it, which is called as to-do list. By the way, guys, I have made a video on planner, which is very important in our day-to-day life. This makes our life very organized. The details of the video is given in the card above and the description box below. Please watch it. Next weakness could be I am very detail-oriented. Due to my detail orientation, I cannot move further in any project or any assignment until and unless I am clear of the aim and the objective of the task, which will help me to give my best contribution for its success. So I always carry my note diary along with me for every meeting to capture every important actions and detail. This is used by me quite often, and this makes everything clear in my head. See, I'm having this now as well. Then is dedication. Due to my dedicated nature, I stretch myself, and at times I tend to ignore my health and the time limit, which is not good in long run. So every time I try to put a reminder on my watch or on my system that every couple of hours I need to get up from my seat, do some stretching, have water or have a fruit, this 5 minutes break, you know, really revegetates me. Well, we all should know that we all have weaknesses, and having it is not a flaw. We should accept it and do not hesitate to express them. The person sitting in front of you is an interviewer. The person who is sitting in front of you is a human being as well. He is also having few weaknesses. With my experience over the years, I have observed that candidates are not very comfortable in answering it, and they feel that they will be judged on this. Yes, you will be judged, but then putting up fair things across the table is always better. So that you know what it is, and when you also talk about your countermeasures, it shows that you are working on your self-improvement. So try to turn your weakness in your strength. Coming to the strength part of this video, we will be talking how we can club 2 to 3 strength of ours into a statement, as I have mentioned in one of my tip above. So here we start. I am a team player. This helps me to get involved in most of the projects assigned to my team. With this, I am updated with overall productivity of the team, and with my creative thinking and problem-solving approach, I can assist them whenever they are stuck. This is what you have highlighted is team player, creative thinking, problem-solving approach. Now you have to add a real-time incident to it. So we start. In my previous employer, once when our sales number was not happening for a region for a refrigerator product line, I came out with special discounts. If it was purchased by the customers on their special days like birthdays, anniversaries, etc., we would give them special discounts. So this was my creative thinking, and I solved the problem for my team. Coming to the next statement. I'm generally known for my commitment and determination. Recently, we had deadlines to release a project, but due to last moment technical issues, this release was getting hampered, and I stretched my hours and resolved the problem from not only the root and ensured that our client requirements are met on time. So here you're talking about your commitment and your determination. The strength can be anything. Okay, now here I'm just showing an example where knowledge sharing is my strength. So how will I put? Knowledge sharing is my habit. I ensure whenever I learn something new out of my experience or attending by any workshop, I always pass it on to my teammates, to the family members. So the knowledge is updated to them as well. This is applicable not only in professional life, but I also try to do it in my personal life, and I have experienced this really helps others and my team to stay up to date. Another example. This also shows that there is future preparedness, what you believe in, not only for yourself, but for others as well. I am naturally a people person, and my convincing communication skills adds to it. At times, leadership takes my help to if they want to communicate or roll out any new policies, not only internally in the organization, but while dealing with external stakeholders also. And I'm proud of it. I am happy to help them with my influencing skills for betterment of the company. So in this, we have spoken about people, person, good communication skills, and influencing skills. The last example, I have a tendency to go to the root of any issue and analyze it from all the possible angles and take corrective actions to avoid future occurrence of such issues again and again. With this, you can add any incident to it. I have just given few examples. You need to frame the answers to this question around your real strengths and weaknesses. If you have any questions, please comment in the comment section below, and I will be glad to come back to you. Please do not forget to view, like, share, and subscribe to my channel One Door HR. Also, you can visit us on www.onedoorhr.com. Follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and Pinterest. I hope this video was also helpful to you like the previous video. Please ensure to keep on following the series so that you are ready to face the interview. All the best, and thank you very much for your time.